All right, if you're using a Google Sheets table, so that will look something like what I have on the screen here. It has the header controls on it. You can do something called a table reference. So this is a new way to refer to data inside the table that's going to allow you to work faster and make your formulas a little bit more readable. All right, so let's dive in. So this Google Sheets table has two things that are going to enable these references. One of them is a table name and then the column names. So let's use the table name first, and we're going to make our first table reference. And we are just going to say, we're just going to type a T, and then Google Sheets will give us these references. So the first one is just, we're just going to say table one. And I'm going to type enter, but the formula's not done yet, but I want to show you what happens. I'm going to type enter, and Google Sheets says, wait, there's more than one value in that reference. I don't know what to do with it. So when you use these alone like this, you have to tell Google Sheets, this is an array, and I want you to write out all the values. So that's what the array formula does. Hit enter. And when you reference a table in the way that we just did, it writes out all the contents. All right, so that's the first way to do it. You will notice that the headers are missing. And if you want those, there is a modifier that you can add, which is, I'll just use the autocomplete. It's here, it's a hashtag and an all. Hit enter on that, and that returns the headers. All right, and the third and final way that you can reference a table, and this is what we'll be using in formulas here in a minute, is by specifying a specific column. So instead of saying all, let's say we want the cost, right? We'll just say cost. And that type of reference just grabs one column. Now it grabs the entire column. And here's the difference between this reference and a regular reference. So by regular reference, I mean if you just typed in C2 through C5. And you still need the array formula around this. So Sheets knows what to do with it. And it writes out the same thing, right? So you're wondering, well, why would I bother using a different syntax? It's a little bit confusing to use one or the other, right? Well, the difference is if you expand this table, so Google Sheets tables, they have some extra capabilities. They have expanded smarts. And one of them is that if you add a row underneath it, it will expand the table. So let's just say there's more impressions here on this one. Hit enter. It added that to the table. And if you'll notice, oh, I put it in the wrong column. The cost of those was large. It was $88 million. And the table column reference picked that up. Okay, so these references have the added ability to get new data as it's added to the table. And if you delete something, let's delete two of these rows. I can't do them one at a time, it's weird. Delete table row, and we'll delete one more. Delete table row. Both of them updated, but this array formula actually has an empty cell at the bottom that it's returning. But the table column reference is not. It's only returning three rows. All right, now we're going to use these references inside formulas. That's what they're made for, right? We use them without formulas just to show what's going into them, but now let's get something back out of them. You can use them inside the table if you want. So let's insert a column to the left, and we'll just take the cost and we'll enact inflation on it, right? So we'll say array formula, and then we will say cost times 1.0, I think the latest number was 3%. Hit enter. And it applied the inflation rate to every column, right? So that's handy. But you can also just use some regular cell reference here. So let's just do C2 times 1.03. And we'll copy that down. So in a way it's an extra step, but it's a simpler formula. in this table, because it's a Google Sheets table and it's a little bit smart, if you add a row, it will expand that formula. Okay, so you can use these inside tables. They provide more value outside of tables, referencing into them. So I will show you one of those. Let me delete this row again. All right, let's say we want to find the cost per impression. So that means we need to sum both of those. We need to sum the impressions, we need to sum the cost, and then divide the two. We don't need the array formula here because we want one number divided by another number. Okay, these sums will just output one number. So they'll take the arrays into them, right? Do the sum operation and then the division. So let me type this out. So what we're going to do, we're going to do sum of the impressions, and I'll just use my mouse, right? It'll write the table reference, table column reference for me. And I will divide that by, type out sum again, cost. So remember, this is an array, all the values of the impressions, and they're getting added, so then they turn into one number. And then the costs come in as an array of three numbers. They're added together, so they also turn into one number. So then this is just regular division. I hit enter, and it's $1, but I need to increase that so it shows a little bit more precision. 85 cents per impression. That's terribly expensive. You should fire your marketer. Anyway, all right, if you want more information about these tables and how they operate, I'll link to a video right now about being a comprehensive guide of Google Sheets tables and what all of these cool little controls can do for you. I'll see you in that video. Thanks for watching.